Happy holidays, everyone. Ah, Christmas, my favorite holiday. I love the spirit and happiness that this holiday brings. One thing I love especially is the music. Christmas music, as overplayed as it can be, is never tiring to me. I would rather hear these joyful songs 2 months a year instead of which mellow radio filler plays through the next 10. But there was this song that somebody requested me that which is considered to be a very crazy Christmas song from the Grammy Award winning artist Lady Gaga. Lady Gaga, huh? I've lived through the legacy of Miss Gaga. She's a very unique and even talented artist. I remember the days of Just Dance, the barrier smashing Born This Way, the breezing Perfect Illusion, so much more, and also Rain on Me. So yeah, Lady Gaga is a bona fide pop star. Alright, but this Christmas song from her is from 2008? Wow, this was her old days. Let's feel and spread the holiday cheer, and let's press play on Christmas Tree. Well, okay, this is an interesting way to start out a song. Usually, like, the first few seconds of a song in general is supposed to lure you in and give you an idea of what the rest of the song is going to sound like. And this is especially relevant in Christmas songs.
It's the most wonderful time of the year.
Just hear the sleigh bells jingling, ring, ting, tingling too.
Wow, this is tough to listen to.
Light me up, put me on top, let's la 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 la. Light me up, put me on top, let's la 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 la.
Instrumental aside, Lady Gaga singing on this is kind of weird.
The only place you'll wanna be is underneath my Christmas tree.
Why are you singing these lyrics like you are a robot? 2008.
The only place you wanna be is underneath my Christmas tree.
Yeah, because who doesn't want to be underneath Lady Gaga's Christmas tree? Wait.
Light me up, put me on top, let's la 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 la.
Her singing and vocals are so weird in this, though. I don't even know if this is, like, intentional or not. It's so draggy and it's so sloppy. I mean, I don't even know.
Ho, 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 under the mistletoe. Yes, everybody knows we will take off our clothes.
Take our clothes off? Wait a minute.
You, oh, Christmas, my Christmas tree's delicious. Oh, oh, Christmas, my Christmas tree's delicious.
My Christmas tree is delicious? Why would a tree be in this case delicious? Oh. I just realized what this song is about. In this case, I don't think YouTube likes this, one word specifically, but, this song is about having Oh, it's gonna be like that, huh? Well, in this case, I'm gonna pull a She-Hulk.
This menu is not gonna stop me. I'm just gonna break this inhibitor real quick. Alright, let's see here. No, yeah, no.
My channel.
That'll do.
Okay, so as of me looking up the genius definition of this song, Lady Gaga states that Christmas Tree is about the spirit of celebrating the most joyous holiday, and I'll tell you why. Because Christmas is the holiday that makes boys and girls feel randy. Wait, randy? Like this guy? Oh, okay, randy in this case means aroused or excited. Oh, okay, that makes sense. I wonder why I didn't understand that. But within some of the annotations, it says that in this segment, Stefani creates a clear allegory. Stefani? Like Gwen Stefani? No, no, no. You better say her name right. You better say Lady Gaga's full name, which is Stefani Joanne Angelina Germanata. I feel like the dumbest mofo on the planet right now. Heard it. Lady Gaga's name is Stefani. Never mind. That was my mistake. Stefani creates a clever allegory. She uses the imagery of Christmas traditions to convey the unusual yet joyous encounter that she experiences. Like Christmas, this encounter is rare, as it only manifests in seasons, but in the seldom instances it manifests, it is a blessing. Stefani likes to be lit up, likely referencing the grim nature of life's transcendence. The encounter is a light amidst the darkness, a rare moment where she can be her true dominant self. Stefani is confident, yet she still asks her lover to assert her dominance, almost giving a symbolic quality. They both meet rarely, but when they do, it's like their nature dictates that they are right for one another, like forces conspiring in the favor of two souls to at last be together. Wow, that was a very poetic way of stating it, but yeah, I actually, within the randomness of this song, I will say there is like a clever idea here, and I will say this, that this song kind of stands out for being different lyrically and even production-wise. And also another annotation that describes the whole lyric of "the only place you want to be is underneath my Christmas tree." It describes, and as I say, in this section, Stefani creates a reassertion of her imminent dominance. She assures her lover about her most innocuous desires. I'm so sorry if I'm pronouncing some of these words wrong. My throat's kind of ish, you know. Even if things escalate, there will be no fight or struggle. Stefani reigns supreme here. Only she can be on top, but her lover won't mind. They will be beneath the Christmas tree. Yeah. Both souls co-assign peacefully as their whims are fulfilled in this ecstatic encounter. The truest thing about this annotation is that only she can be on top. Lady Gaga's always on top. That's right. That's right. That's right. That's right. That's right. That's right. Number one. Number one. Oh my god, this is so crazy. Oh, and also I heard there's like a music guest on the song named Space Cowboy.
Light you up, put you on top. Let's fa la 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 la. Let's go. Ho, ho, ho. Under the mistletoe.
Is this Lil Yachty? I'm just kidding. Ah, Christmas cheer. Oh, this definitely sounds like a Christmas song now. I forgot there is another instrumental attached to this.
Best time of the year. Take off my stockings, we're out spreading Christmas cheer.
You're definitely spreading cheer, all right.
Space Cowboy, Lady Gaga, Lady Gaga.
Lady Gaga, Lady Gaga.
Here we go.
Cherry, cherry, boom, boom.
Damn, I don't even think Frank Sinatra would have landed that note as good as she did.
I know that's right!
Oh, would you look at that? There's an annotation of the last line. Cherry, cherry, boom, boom. The way Gaga sings this last part could possibly mean that she reached the climax of the story after spending the whole song trying to connect with her boyfriend. And this is her way to tell you Merry Christmas. Okay, all jokes aside, I actually think this song is interesting. It definitely keeps your attention. It definitely like calls for your attention, like even like the production. Like, this song came out in 2008, and I mean, it's not a popular Christmas song, so I don't think it gets played like every year, honestly. I probably gave this more attention than it has had in like the past 14 years, honestly. But actually, I find Christmas Tree to be kind of intriguing in a way. I give it like a 6 out of 10, but this is like a generous 6 out of 10, though. I mean, like, the 6 out of 10 is still kind of like a positive score, though. Let's just be completely honest here. But other than that, Lady Gaga is still making good tracks today, especially the album Chromatica. And Christmas is still a wonderful time to share with everybody, spreading Christmas cheer. Have a great holiday and happy new year. And more videos are going to be coming soon. So long and good night.
Have a holly jolly Christmas. It's the best time of